One of my members asked me why jazz, why listen to jazz? And I think that's a really good question because when I listen to music, I listen to lots of different types of music, and it's not always jazz that does it for me. You know, in certain situations, I want to listen to rock music, to listen to pop music, but I very often come back to jazz as a sort of a method of study. I think the main reason for this is that it's got a little bit more arguably sophistication than some other types of music. And don't get me wrong, I really love rock and pop music, but sometimes it's a little bit like, you know, if you're having pop music is like a hamburger. You know, there are times when you just really want a really nice hamburger, but it's not particularly sophisticated. It just does what it does very, very well, and it kind of hits the spot. But sometimes you want a little bit more. And particularly when you're trying to study music, when you're practicing music at home, if you're studying pop music, a lot of that is to do with the simplicity and the kind of the production of it, the fact that you've just got exactly what is needed at exactly the right time. And that's, you know, there's some study to be done on that, and don't get me wrong, you know, I'm not sort of knocking pop music in any way, but in order to study something which has got a little bit more to it, jazz kind of does it for me. Some people with classical music, some people, you know, contemporary music, I do a little bit of that as well. But jazz, again, I just keep coming back to it. So one of the things I've been listening to recently is this album here. It's a very popular Sonny Rollins album. It's got a little bit of history to it. You can look up the history behind The Bridge, the album The Bridge. For me, it's a fantastic Sonny Rollins album, and I love hearing him play. He's got a sound which I aspire to. It's not exactly the sound that I go for, and it's certainly not the sound that I get. I kind of mix a few influences up for the sound that I want, but just to listen to the sound of his tenor is wonderful. So apart from the sort of the sound of the tenor, which, you know, if obviously I'm practicing a tenor saxophone, I want to have some influence for that. I'm also listening to the feel and the rhythm and the melody and all of these things jazz pretty much does. You know, you can dip into it and you can find a level of depth which is beyond a lot of other styles. This is what I found studying jazz. You can really go into the theory, you can go into the feel of it. You really have to spend time with the feel and repeating that feel in order to get it to sound natural. And I really like that approach. It's almost like you're studying a language. You know, you can learn all the vocabulary, but you have to go to that country in order to kind of use it properly and to understand how things are put together and not to sound like a robot when you're, you know, trying to communicate with other people. And if you immerse yourself in this style, if you just listen to this sort of music all the time, then it will start to rub off and you will start to sound like them. So the time feel is really important. It's like the thing that amazes me about all these sort of jazz giants is that their timing is so impeccable. They can play things, they can execute things really, really precisely, but they have this knack of making it sound natural and laid back and kind of behind the beat. They can kind of play with the beat, whether they want to push it forward, whether they want to play it absolutely bang on, or whether they want to play behind the beat a little bit. Dexter Gordon, I suppose, was a very famous example of somebody who really drew the rhythm back, so you kind of had this very sort of laid back feel. I guess the other thing that really does it for me in terms of jazz is that you've got a huge amount of improvisation, and I love the fact that all of this stuff is coming on the spot. You know, it's Sonny Rollins in a recording studio, and what he decides to play on that day at that exact second is just genius. You know, the whole idea of composing something on the spot like that, it's, you know, it's absolutely amazing. Composition, you would find that you would play something, you'd think, oh, that sounds pretty good, or that doesn't quite work, I'm going to just rejig that a little bit. And you'll go through draft 1, draft 2, draft 10, draft 20, and then eventually you would come up with something that sounds amazing. And I guess that's what happens in rock and pop music. You know, I know rock and pop musicians, and they say they have to lay down the same track over and over and over, partly to, in terms of the rock world, to layer it up. I know a guitarist in the rock world who does the same line 10, 20 times just to kind of beef up the track a little bit. Anyway, in a way it's so prescribed because it's been thought about and then it's been edited and rejigged and just put in exactly the right place. And, you know, I love that about pop music and rock music, but jazz, it's whatever's draft one is the final thing. You know, it's just, it's amazing how they come up with these things first go. So listening to the improvisation, you can kind of get a sense of how the idea that he's got is developing. And Sonny Rollins is a really good example of this, where there's an idea, a melodic idea or a phrase, which he repeats and develops. Now, how many people, when they improvise, can say that they would play a phrase and be able to remember exactly what phrase they just played and then play it straight back again? All too often you'll hear improvisers, they'll just spew out a load of notes. And yeah, okay, it can sound kind of good and impressive, but here, Sonny Rollins is really kind of developing the idea and repeating it and allowing you in. It's kind of giving you these little hooks, you know, in the same sense as pop music would give you a very repetitive hook. He's kind of doing that as well. So the first chorus that you listen to, he's playing all pretty much based around one note. It's just the root note. So all his phrases are coming back to that. Some are exactly the same. Some have got little twists and turns in them, but he keeps coming back to that same note. And it just kind of draws you in and draws you in and draws you in. And then all of a sudden, the second chorus, he's got you and he'll just go. I love about that is the structure of it, how they kind of make it interesting. And the structure is actually very simple. The form is very simple. You've got a section of 8 bars, which is then repeated. So we've got section A and then section A again. Then we've got a bridge, so we call that section B, and then it goes back to section A again. So each one are 8 bars. And this is classic song form, that's what it's called. But he puts in a nice little trick of just handing it over to the guitarist to play the bridge. I love to hear is the communication between the rest of the musicians. So they were all sat in the studio and I would have thought pretty much playing this live, and you can hear that there's a change in feel, and it's kind of prescribed in a way, but it feels very natural. So for instance, you can hear the bass player throughout the A section, particularly at the beginning, and through Sonny's first solo, first chorus of the solo, he's playing almost like a 2 feel, dun, ga-dun, ga-dun, ga-dun. And he's putting in occasional crotchets, But most of the time he's playing on 1 and 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Dun, da-dum, 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 da-dum. So it's got a 2 feel. Every time he goes to the bridge, he starts to walk and he's playing on every beat then, every crotchet. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's where it really starts to pick up and swing. So it's not like rock music where it's like the chorus is, you know, move to the ride cymbal, hit everything much harder and a big sort of power chorus. It's much more subtle than that, but it's got the same sort of effect where this idea of the new section, it kind of lifts. And he does that as well in the solo. So the first time through AABA, apart from the bridge where it does swing, the bass player is playing on 1 and 3 again on those minims, pretty much. And then in Sonny's second chorus, he starts to really swing and he starts to go into this walking bass, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And it just gives the whole thing a lift. And you can also hear that Sonny starts to change the way he plays then. So it kind of, again, going back to this idea of you've got kind of warmed up to it. He's kind of got you hooked with his first chorus, with all that repetition and that sort of twisting of the same phrase and the development of that phrase. And then all of a sudden, it's into that swinging, you know, kind of driving swing beat in the second chorus. And you can listen to all of that. And although it's much more complicated, you're kind of there with him. And the other thing I like is that even though there's a lot of notes going on, and that's a, people often say that about jazz, that they play way too many notes and it's just, they're making it up as they go along and they're just playing absolute nonsense. Yes, they are making it up as they go along. I wouldn't say they're playing absolute nonsense, but there are a lot of notes in there. But actually, still, he's playing space in between those phrases, so it kind of makes sense. It's like playing a phrase which is like a sentence, and then he leaves a pause and then moves on to something else. And with Sonny, you can really hear that. I mean, there are other players where it does kind of move from one phrase to another phrase very quickly, and it seems like it's not happening like that. And it just seems like lots and lots and lots and lots. But that's truly what he's trying to do there. And it does, for me, I can hear that, and it kind of makes sense to me. So there you go. A couple of things about Sonny Rollins, the album The Bridge. That song was called Without a Song. And a couple of things there that I really enjoy listening to when I'm listening to jazz. And some things that I try and absorb. As a musician, I'm always listening and always trying to take things from what I can hear. And with jazz, really that's what it does for me. I can take so much from one thing. It's a real bang for your buck kind of piece of music. Whereas other styles, you know, I would put some pop or rock music on when I'm, you know, having dinner or driving in the car. But with jazz, it's like you can really immerse yourself in it. And it's like one of those headphone moments where you can just lose yourself and answer so many questions about what's happening, that it's actually quite a nice sort of brain exercise as well. So I hope you got something from that as well. Perhaps you could leave a comment of the sort of music that you like listening to. Perhaps it's jazz, perhaps it's not. Perhaps you completely disagree and you think that you can get all sorts of complicated stuff from rock and pop music. I'm sure you can. And classical music, of course, as well. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you didn't like it. Thanks very much. I'll see you on another one.